Hi class, it's Miss Best, and this is a quick video to go over the features of Google Classroom just in case you've never used it before. So once you're in your drive, you can hit the waffle and click on the classroom application. The course we're taking is Best 11U English, and the course code is 39NRKCB. So when you get to the home page, you're going to see stream, classwork, people, grades. What you're going to use most are stream and classwork. Stream is the list of assignments, materials, activities, anything upcoming and anything I've posted. The most recent is posted at the top, and then it moves down to the next recent, and so on and so forth. Classwork is organized according to topics, and if you can see, all of our topics are listed under this table of contents here. I can click on any of these and it will take me to the unit that we're talking about, and it also will open up all the assignments in that unit. So this is our poetry unit. If I go back to all topics, at the beginning I keep the course outline and the course calendar. The course calendar is something that you're going to be referring to for the entire semester, and I'll be updating it as we go along. Keep your eye on it because it'll help you stay on track. Another feature of this, a new feature of Google Classroom, is grades. So anytime you have an assignment that must be submitted, once you've submitted that assignment, I've graded, you'll see your grades. These aren't official grades. The grades on Teach Assist will be your official grade, but these are just to let you know how you've done and where you are as far as this particular assignment is concerned. Scrolling down, you'll see right now I can only see this because this is the teacher view, but in student view you would only see the ones that aren't grayed out. Another feature is your to-do list. So the to-do list, any class that you have that is using a Google Classroom, because you're a GAPS user, all of your Google Classroom classes will be listed here, and you can easily see all assignments due from all your classes, or you can just select your class and see what assignments are due in your English class. So the final thing I'll share with you is in classwork, certain things are assignments and certain things are materials. For example, when I create, I can create an assignment, a quiz assignment, I can ask a question, material, or create a new topic. Assignments are the things that will have grades, and materials are the things that you use, like the content of the lesson. So the materials icon looks like this, and the assignment icon looks like a little clipboard. So just know that those are the difference. Assignment, you will have to complete it and turn it in for it to register that you've finished the work. Okay, I hope this helps, and good luck this semester.